what? Three? It's the third day here. Yeah. So today we are way more refreshed. Cause I'm willing to put on contact lenses. That's how refreshed I am. So today we're gonna go to the War Memorial. War Memorial? No. The 9/11 Memorial. Yes. I got another hat.
So I got my own scarf.
He got his own scarf now.
Yeah.
Yeah, we went to Zara just now. Yeah. As usual, we're like dressing on the go. So now we're gonna go to the World Trade Center
Memorial.
And then we're gonna explore.
Nice.
It's a call.
Nice. Oh,
take a photo of you.
Me?
Yeah.
Currently at ground zero, the place where one half of the World Trade Center used to be, after the 9/11 attack. I think we are old enough to remember that incident. At least I think I was old enough to remember. I was still only in P5, I think, or P6. I remember waking up, there was a lot of news, big hoo-ha on the news, and I was being told that there's no school for that day. If I remember correctly, there was no school that day. As a kid, I was just happy to not have school on that day. But later on, when I grew older and I understand the significance of this unfortunate event, yeah. Now that memory is not a pleasant memory to live with. I mean, I'm not going to pretend I'm overly sad or anything, but just to see all the names being engraved on this. A lot of lives were lost. It doesn't really matter which side of the story that you believe in, whether it was a conspiracy, whether it was really a terrorist attack. Definitely lives were lost. That's all that matters.
I was just telling Zahir that it's amazing how this one spot was targeted. There are so many buildings around. I'm not just wondering what could have gone through the minds of like the people who planned this. Like, what was the point? Spread terror! Yeah, probably that was the point. But a lot of people died. So, I mean, sentiments aside, the people who live on and experience what happened here must be really traumatized, and they can never forget it for life, because it could have been them. Like, I mean, look at like all the buildings around us. There are so many buildings. There's like thousands of people all around. And like, it could be like even the people just walking past the building, they were also affected because of the plane crash. Can you imagine? The debris and stuff. Like, people were freaking scared. I mean, I just cannot. So he said I can buy another one. I was like, what? I can buy another one? Sure. I love you.
Okay.
TMG.
Oh my god, you don't want to sing, is it?
Silly kind of person.
He's your what?
Silly.
Silly?
Silly. 50.
Oh, he's a 50 kind of person. Yeah. Found it. Found it. Yeah. I'm gonna continue recording until this song is done. Oh my god. Hello! 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 It's over. And now he plays Usher. From the start, that one for me. Say something.
I'm nearly.
Okay, so we are currently at the Charging Bull.
Raging Bull.
Yep, on 26 Broadway. Yep. At least it's civilized. Everybody be queuing. So actually we're just walking here at Wall Street. Let's see if we can see the Flatiron building. Flatiron building. This is the New York Stock Exchange Financial District. We are here, New York Stock Exchange. Look at this. They have a nice big fat tree. Big fat tree. I was hoping to see a big fat tree at Rockefeller Center, but yesterday it was too jam and packed. So here we are. So tell us, sir, where are we now?
So we're at the Federal Hall National Memorial, where you can see a statue of George Washington on the front steps of the Federal Hall, which is a memory of Washington's inauguration as the country's first president. Yes, I learned that all when I was in primary school.
Yeah, right. So anyway, that's where we are. Here's where we are. Right here. This is where we are at. This is the Federal Hall.
So this is the birthplace of American democracy.
She's totally winging it, guys. So this is basically Wall Street. Anything business is here, because the New York Stock Exchange is there. And then, so on this side in Federal Hall, April 30th, 1789, George Washington took the oath as the first president of the United States of America. Ah, I see. So this place is important because George Washington took his oath as Presidente
of the United States of America. So yeah, we had a very historical building. Over 200 plus years. It's still standing tall, I guess.
Hi George Washington. Adios. So, what I noticed about George Washington, he has a belly. And he's got the selfie knee. Come, I show you. Can you see it? And you see it? Oh my god, you can't see it. Okay. See? You see? Look at his belly. Look at that. He got that selfie knee and that belly already.
Yeah.